But praise God. Our final speaker this morning is a mighty man of God. A couple years ago, you know, Pastor Larry was in the Philippines, you know, doing ministry there years ago, and he met a young man and he started collaborating with him, and that was Pastor Sammy Morris, who is with the Lord now. And we've seen probably the most fruitful and evident ministry of multiplication has come out of the wonderful nation of the Philippines, where multiplication, I don't want to say the word multiplication, I'd rather just say it's Filipino, because they define multiplication. You know, there's so many churches there, and the ministry's just very fruitful. And after Pastor Sammy's passing, you know, there was some restructuring that was going on. Pastor Larry was there, and Pastor Noli has always been there alongside Pastor Sammy and Naomi as they were ministering. They were, I believe him and his wife were the first people to be alongside them. You guys were you the first church plant or sent out church? Yeah? And so he's been alongside Pastor Sammy Morris, Pastor Noli, his right-hand man, for years. And we are so grateful and so honored to have Pastor Noli come up here, Pastor Noli, and to see the dynamic, fruitful work that's going on. They're still multiplying. They're still making disciples. And Pastor Noli, thank you so much for being here. We look forward to this message. And we know you're gonna bring an amazing word this morning. Praise God. Thank you, Pastor Noli. Yeah, I'm a big guy. But he's a greater, bigger guy.
Praise the Lord. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Good morning. Laki masyado ah. Okay, thank you. And I'm so happy for this time. Not because Pastor Sammy died. I'm happy for this morning because the vision of this fellowship is still alive. So it's my honor to be part of this conference as we are a BB Church from the Philippines. And today, I have my wife, my beautiful wife. And Pastor Lori, one of our leaders in our fellowship in the Philippines. And we have Pastor Charlie and his wife. Amen, from the Philippines. And also, we have Filipino church in Bay Area from the leadership of Pastor Earl Patino. And they are there. And also Pastor Lito Atienza and his wife. And we have Filipino churches and all over the world, not only in the Philippines. And thank you so much for recognizing and acknowledging us as Filipino. So, first of all, I thank the Lord, our God in heaven, that He is our God in our fellowship, the Praise Chapel and Victory Church in the Philippines. And also, I would like to thank Pastor Larry and Janet Neville who brought the vision, win, build, and send. And Pastor Sammy and Sister Noemi received this vision to win souls, building disciples, and send out pastors. I was remembered 1986, me and my wife, Pastor Sammy, sent out us in Tondo, Manila. And when I start my pioneering, we have pastors meeting. Three of us, that was 1987. Three of us sitting on the table with coffee, because we are addicted coffee. And we talk about winning souls, building disciples, and church planting. And you know, this agenda is we will plant church all over the Philippines. And after 41 years, 100 of churches planted in the Philippines. Because we have vision. And last year, Pastor Sammy passed away. And he planted 100 of churches in the Philippines. But now, the question, when Pastor Sam is gone, he died last year, maybe, what is in your mind when you have a news that Pastor Sam is passed away? Winning souls, building disciples, and church planting will stop? For us, as a Filipino, is very big no. We don't stop to win souls. We don't stop building disciples. We don't stop plant churches. Actually, last February, when Pastor Larry was been preaching our conference, we plant 100 of pastors. Even Pastor Sammy was not there. Amen? So, this is because we are talking about multiplication. This conference is about making disciples and multiply churches. For me, since 1987, when we start our pioneering, you know, making disciples, winning souls, for me, this is unintentional. Not making the good story. Soul winning is about telling the truth about the good news about Jesus. It's talking about the winning souls is to go around to preach the gospel, not to stay in your church, do nothing. So for me, evangelism is intentional, and also making disciples, this is intentional. Jesus Christ is from heaven. He is not going to this earth to play games, but he's looking somebody. It's talking about making disciples. Amen? And most of all is planting churches. This is unintentional. We are not stopped to plant churches. Actually, we have more than 20 conferences in the Philippines. When Pastor Larry, right after Pastor Samis died, he stayed in the Philippines about 1 month to confirm the leadership in the Philippines. Before Pastor Larry, stay only in Metro Manila. But I told to Pastor Larry, you need to go around all over the Philippines to witness our little or small conferences. our small conference is about like 200 to 300 people. We go around Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. And after 1 month, he confirmed the leadership of our church in the Philippines. It's strong. Then he come back here in California. So we are still kicking, more stronger. Amen? Because of our vision, winning souls, building disciples, and church planting. We don't stop. So, my topic this morning is the greatest command is multiply. That is the, from the beginning of creation, multiplication has been central, the purpose and agenda of God for humanity. In Genesis chapter 1 verse 28, then God blessed them. Hallelujah. And God said to them, be fruitful and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it. And this is the greatest command from our God. The first thing God asked to do was multiply. In other words, divine multiplication has been around since the beginning of time. To command the humanity, his creation, to be fruitful first. Because you cannot multiply without the fruit. And you cannot fill the earth if you have no multiple, if you cannot multiply. Hallelujah. So God wants to partner with you to multiply in every area of life. It's so important to God that He didn't just ask us to multiply, but He's commanding us to multiply. It means to produce more souls. Hallelujah. Don't stay in your very cold church. That's why I'm wearing my jacket, because for me, I'm got nervous. Because I'm feel cold. Hallelujah. Don't stay in your church. The command of God in Matthew chapter 28, go. Preach, teach, and make disciples. Hallelujah, more pastors to be sent out every city, every nation, countries. That's what Pastor Larry did. 1982, he brought his whole family in the Philippines. They stayed not 1 week. They stayed there not 1 month. They stayed there 7 years. Right, Pastor Paul? That's why Pastor Paul is an American Filipino. Because he grew up there. There is one part of his blood is Filipino. Hallelujah. So because without winning souls, we have no disciples. Because after winning soul, you bring your sinners inside the church and then touch them. Show them. Teach them. Disciple them. A And if we become strong enough, they know everything, what the church going on. So, send out. So number one, I would like to talk with you the response to divine multiplication. What is your response to divine multiplication? Divine means this is God. It's about God. He is the one who multiply. Not you. Not the church. Not Pastor Sammy. Not Pastor Larry. But it's about God. Hallelujah. When I read the book of John chapter 6, beginning verses 1 to 13, a lot of people gathered and received healing from Jesus, which led to the feeding of the 5,000. And it's believed that when you add women and children to the count, this crowd was probably more like 15,000 or more. This is a lot of people to feed. And all it took was 5 loaves and 2 fish combined with the divine multiplication. I would like to share with you the principle of divine multiplication. Giving, sharing, and distributing. The young boy gave his 2 fish and 5 loaves. The disciples, they start to share to the people. If you will imagine, when Jesus, after he prayed for this 2 fish and 5 loaves, and Jesus gave to his disciples, I researched why 5 loaves only and 2 fish. In my mind, it's not an equal. Because imagine, Jesus had 12 disciples. Now, after Jesus prayed, 7 elements only, 2 fish and 5 loaves. This is my, in my mind, what in my mind, there are 7 only. So Jesus gave to the 7 disciples. And up to now, I research whose names Jesus gave the 7 elements. Then, for me, maybe the 5 other disciples, they are absent in this event, in that event. Like today, maybe pastors, they are not here. They are absent. But still, Jesus is in control. Because number 7 is perfect number. That's why there is a miracle when Jesus gave this 2 fish and 5 loaves. They start to share. Hallelujah. The young boy gave this 2 fish and 5 barley loaves. And the disciples, they share to the people. And the people, they help to distribute to their family of their and also their neighborhood, their companions. So miracle happened that moment because Jesus was there. So we need to know if Jesus in our ministry, in our activities, any kind of works in the church, be sure Jesus is with us. Hallelujah. Jesus watching over his disciples. Jesus watching what they did. The disciples starting to share this 5 loaves. And the parents, they accept that bread. And of course, if I am the parents, I am the father, I want to share first to my children. So, Jesus was there giving, sharing, distributing. And while Jesus watching over them, Jesus glorified. He's glad. He's happy. That's why 12 baskets left over are collected. Hallelujah. Even the pastors, even the 5 disciples was not there. But Jesus still gave to the absent disciples still 12 baskets. Reserve that to my disciples. So this is the divine multiplication. And this is what God done to the Philippines. Hallelujah. We have the same God. Your God here in Priest Chapel is the same our God in the Philippines, the Victory Church. So the need of multiplication. Number 2. Acts chapter 2 verse 4. The Holy Spirit. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in another tongues. And the Spirit gave them utterance. So remember, the upper room, there is 500 members to wait upon the Lord, to wait the promise of God that the Holy Spirit comes, but didn't wait. They skip. Hallelujah. They go down. But there were 120 believers in an upper room. Wait. The Holy Spirit that Jesus had promised. The promise is Acts chapter 1 verse 8. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. Hallelujah. That's the promise of God. Because I believe multiplication is you can do that with the help of the Holy Spirit. So they all received the Holy Spirit, spoke another tongues, and then Peter gave a powerful message to people who were struggling to believe what had just happened. After his message, look at what happened in Acts chapter 2, verse 41. Those who believe that Peter said were baptized and added to the church that day about 3,000 in all. So that is divine multiplication. The power, the Holy Spirit. Don't forget the purpose of the Holy Spirit in us is to cleanse us, our inner life, in and out, no compromising, live a holy life, Stay where you are. Be loyal to your pastor. Be faithful to your pastor. Obey to your pastor. Submit to your pastor. Honor to your pastor. In 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 58, say, therefore, my beloved brothers, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the works of the Lord, knowing that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. In one Sunday, your church went from 120 people to 3,000 in one Sunday. That's what you call divine multiplication. To multiply, we need the Holy Spirit because the Holy Ghost will give you boldness to preach the gospel wherever you go, any kind of people. That's why when Pastor Larry went to the Philippines, intentional. His winning souls is intentional. He did not stay in his house to drive a car. He did not stay in the church. But, hallelujah, he brought us in the street. Bring horn, bring the amplifier. And he began to street preaching. Because winning souls is intentional. The sinners, they did not come to your church. You need to bring them. Hallelujah. To tie them and bring the church to purge them. Hallelujah. So the Holy Spirit, so God is our God. He anoint us. We have the anointing to win souls, to disciples and church planting. So this conference is about winning souls. We will not multiply if we will stay in our church. This word, making disciple, I tell you the truth, this is unintentional. And church planting, this is unintentional. Don't wait to the pastors from another church that they rebel to their pastors, and if they will come to your church and you will lunch out. No. You're making big problem in your church if you will do that. Hallelujah. So, church planting is easy way to win souls, plant and your disciples to another city. So please don't allow your disciples to stay in the church. Bring them to the street. Bring them to the market. Bring them to the buses, to the train, and even in the air while you are riding airplane. Hallelujah. So, pastors, I want to challenge you. Impart what is in your heart. Don't be lazy. From now on, commit yourself not to watching television 10 hours. Not to go around without do nothing. Commit yourself as a servant of God. Hallelujah. To preach the gospel. Don't be professional disciples. Take off your jacket and take off your ano tawag dito? Necktie. And wear your t-shirt. and preach to the poor, preach to the unsaved people, to the homeless people. Preach anywhere. Hallelujah. Because winning souls is intentional. Discipleship is intentional. And church planting is intentional. And this is the mandate of our God since the beginning. God blessed us. Genesis 1:28. We receive already blessing from the Lord that we can able to be fruitful. Amen? We have no reason because God put the genetic code inside of us. Genetic means the original. Jesus is the original and his life imparted to his disciples. And as a disciple, if you receive that genetic, you impart to the sinners. Hallelujah! Let us give clap offerings to the Lord. And I want to call our musician, please. Let's stand together. I'm done. Hallelujah. Because land's waiting to us. But before, as a senior pastor from the Philippines, you know, Pastor Sammy, he gave everything what is in his life. He did not play games. Now I know why Pastor Sammy every time when he come here in your country, he always insisting me, okay, Noli, get your ticket. Then I whispering to my wife, can I use your credit card? Because we fly 15 hours to attend conference. So we pay our own ticket. I am not trusting Pastor Sammy to pay my ticket. We have a lot of sacrifice. You are blessed, Pastor, over here. You are blessed. Because one time you eat food like $17, that's one order. That's one family eat that one order. That's for us. That's why you have no reason to win souls, making disciples, and church planting. After you win souls, promise him, go with me in the church and I will bring you Starbucks. If you finish to drink the Starbucks, the souls you won, he is the one who asking you, Pastor, when we go to church again? We have a lot of strategies. Amen? Hallelujah. So now, I would like to challenge you. Maybe this is your struggle. Maybe your church is dying. 5 people only show up in Sunday. 10 people. I attending a special guest Sunday morning. The start of his church is 9:30. That is about 11 o'clock. We did not start. I told him, Pastor, what time we will start? He told me, if the members come, we will start. 11:30, he's starting to set up his guitar. He is the guitarist and he is the song leader. There is 2 people beside me. What happened? You're not doing good. I'm not judging you. But if you don't go out and make disciples and church planting, you are not Priest Chapel. Because our vision, winning souls, build disciples and church planting. So you need to kneel down and repent. Surrender your life. You need fasting and prayer. Before we came here, me and my wife, we passed 3 days pleading to God. Who is me that I stand in this pulpit? Before I have my interpreter, I remember when pastor, he has an interpreter. I point my finger, that's me before. I cannot speak in English. But today, a little bit. Hallelujah. If you are filled the Holy Spirit, you can understand me. Hallelujah. Meaning to say, if God used my life as a small Filipino to reach out all over the Philippines, you can do it also. Before the foundation of this world, Ephesians 1:4, God chose you to be holy and blameless. Meaning to say holy, God separates you to serve Him alone. So don't waste your time. Even me, I am 60 years old already this coming January. Actually, I'm hesitate because if I come to this pulpit, maybe you are thinking this is youth fellowship because your speaker is too young. No, I'm 60 already. I'm getting old. I want my children, the second generation from me, they will taking of my ministry. That's why I told to Pastor Paul, you need to go in the Philippines and Pastor Javier to meet our children. My second son, 12 years pastoring. His church grows. Pastor Lori, his eldest son, he has more than 500 members. He pastoring the church. 500! It's a lot of people. Because we, the Philippines, we serious making disciples. Kaya invite you to come to the altar. Surrender your life. You kneel down. Humble yourself to the Lord. Come on. Even you are not pastor, you are disciples. All of us, women, men, kneel down. Pleading to God. If you need repentance, repent. Say to God, from now on, I will give my life to you, Lord. Hallelujah. Pastor Lori, can go with me. Pastor Lori planted more than 50 churches in the Philippines. Actually, he is the one, because I'm not worthy. Pastor Lori is the one who preaches. But he will come with you to extend his hands to pray with you. How about the others, the members? You know, winning souls, not the work of the pastors. That's the work of the members in the church. Hallelujah. Come on. Hallelujah. Shida rara baba kaya. Thank you, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.